Ava.
Greetings. We don't pierce taints. I cover up crappy tattoos, too. Good.
Yeah, I can go by with it. But it better be worth my time. If I have to pay for it, it's not about it. And you owe me a
lot. Holy crap!
Fuck!
That's it.
Morse Mutual. We're here to help. I think we can handle that.
crap!
Crap!
Business isn't exactly booming, you know.
Damn!
Hey there. You're smart, right?
You're gonna want to see the new stock.
Great choice.
Great. Pleasure doing business with you.
Thank you. I toss him. Ow!
Dickhead! Ah!
Shit!
Oh, shit!
Ow!
What brings you in today? Should be running better than ever.
right? Fuck me! Just perfect!
Thank you. luck out there.
Shoot! Come on down!
Shit!
there looks like the day you bought it.
Thank you. like reality show. Thank you. quick. What you need? Should be cool now.
Oh, man, my one. Oh, oh my fucking god!
Another DOA. Douchebag! Pero que carajo!
What?
Oh, fuck!
On the clock. What you want? Some wheels? It's coming at you. All right, I'll get back to work.
For me, what are you after? Rather safe than sorry, I guess.
Stop indulging them! Watch this! It's just as much fun. Wow, that felt liberating, right?
What a me! I love you, Princess.
Long and hard.
Whoa, that was awesome! But we'll still lose the house, and now we have no fans left.
That's
sorry,
some powerful machinery.
I got the whole thing on my smartphone. Put behind paywall, make episodic or merchandising.
Merchandising! And subverting all the cliches.
And now, if I could get you two to maybe, you know,
no rush at all.
Gravity gun again? Shit novels.
No, we've been shot.
Making decisions is stressful.
This episode makes no sense.
There it is. Life is hard when you can have anything.
A reality show that sends contestants to exotic locations for permanent body modification. Pirates love booty. Why not get ass implants in Somalia? Take a relaxing vacation in Mongolia, the land of Genghis Khan, and get your legs lengthened. Or a second penis installed in Tijuana. Implant Outsource, Mondays on CNT.
If you can think it, I can do it.
Tax the rich on the poor, even though it funnels money offshore.
Impotent rage.
Giddy go awards in a jet plane.
We're sacrificing together. I feel your pain.
Impotent rage.
Eat organic, recycle, or I'll have a fit.
He's a judgmental hypocrite.
Union entitlements rule.
How many cars you got in this garage again? Got some machine under that bonnet. Whatever you desire. Technology and budget permitting.
But we're going out of business if we don't make some changes. They want free snacks, massages, and raises every year. Then most of them go on disability with full pay anyway.
You revolting chiselers, you!
I tried to fire me for sleeping at my desk.
You were drunk! Why, you would be too! He's just dead.
Think long and hard. At all.
I'm extremely rich! I understand how economics work and what the working class needs!
That what you were looking for?
An eager girl in their pickup truck.
And a depressing folk tune playing on the radio. This here's a free checker, boy! Free, but with thousands of rules and regulations to keep greedy corporations like you in line.
If you don't like it, move to China.
But because of the free trade agreement, that's where we'll have to move the company.
Making decisions is stressful.
We just want a sensible discussion of the issue.
Oh, you're nothing short
of a disgrace! If peaceful protest won't change your mind, we're going to have to solve this the old-fashioned way! With mind-bending liberal impotent rage!
Do you need a drink? Bubbles or something? You've got an eye for the stuff.
But our workplace is destroyed.
Ah, hell go on welfare. Kick back. Get a six pack and relax. You deserve it after all this work.
Why do we just want to work?
Braxton Industries, headed by billionaire liberal playboy Braxton Hunter, recently celebrated the closing of another highway to install more bike lanes.
Life is hard when you can have anything.
Braxton recently returned from a trip to Antarctica on his private jumbo jet, where he'd been to accept an environmental
girl is looking
award.
Good.
Some critics say that Hunter is also the caped superhero Impotent Rage, because they look exactly alike and have the same voice, and Impotent Rage tends to show up right after Mr. Hunter quietly...
Don't she look pretty?
He has emphatically denied they are the same person. A hero of the liberal media. Others say Hunter is a rich, entitled asshole with too much time on his hands.
What? I am not a rich, entitled asshole with too much time on my hands.
Looking good.
Now that is one productive day's work. I'm gonna go home and do some yoga, drink some wheat grass, and go to the barber's lodge.
Body work to match the driver.
From who?
Uberman!
My arch nemesis! I hate that right wing boy!
Hey, Impotent Rage, you pathetic hypocrite. I was just eating some whale sashimi and a manatee steak with my...
Looks almost as good as you.
Dumb, slow vegetarians whom the state will no longer protect. See you around, schmucko!
Oh, do I hate that man? Do I despise him?
If you can think it, I can do it.
Take me, rip my clothes off, and thrust yourself inside me. Sometimes I feel like you don't even notice I'm here.
I'm sorry, what were you saying?
How many cars you got in this garage again? Whatever you desire. Technology and budget permitting.
Became a superhero. Through the art of self-meditation, yoga, and a freak green energy accident, which gave me unnatural godlike powers, I became Impotent Rage, 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 Rage. Wait, what's that?
What is it?
It's my echo sense.
Think long and hard.
Off. Batman isn't recycling.
At all.
Braxton,
quick, to the anger room.
Making decisions is stressful.
Plastering. It's exhausting. It's exhausting.
What is it? High-tech device of the future I personally invented, even though I am otherwise entirely incompetent.
Impotent rage. There's some trouble down by the river.
Fascism never sleeps. Violet!
I'm over here.
Of course you are. Why are you wearing that ridiculous outfit?
Do you need a drink? Bubbles or something?
Violet, it's that kind of hyper-sexualized clothing that exploits and demeans women.
Fuck me! Time for impotent rage!
Where is it?
Here.
For the record, this is an organic...
Life is hard when you can have anything.
You're through to your garage. You, need me to bring you a ride? Okay, I got stuff to do.
What are we doing today?
Through
what are you after?
Tunnel Stunt Academy is San Andreas' oldest accredited stunt school. We have classes in high-speed accidents, taking a baseball bat to the face, getting shot, knifed in the back, falling off a building on fire, and getting run over.
No rush at all. They're bulletproof.
Dressing up as them and risking your life. A good driver then needs a good gearbox.
Digitally removed on a green screen.
The Cunning Stunt Academy trains.
Not a bad job.
Have a nice rack. Mine would need stunt tits to show when an A-list celebrity is too bashful or has pancake nipples. The Cunning Stunt Academy. Fame. It's worth any price.
Now that's some kind
what
of entrance.
Cooking show that will have you looking at Fido in all new delicious ways. It's Bow Wow Chow, Dude Eat Dog on CNT.
Whatever you desire, technology and budget permitting.
Santos, the city of celluloid, sin, and cellulite removal. From dead starlets in Vinewood, to the gangbangers in Davis Estrada.
Life is hard when you can have anything.
From Chumash, to the drunken tourists in Del Perro Pier. It's time to take a look inside this cesspit of destroyed dreams. Drug-addled degenerates and deluded desperados that make up this great city of lights. Aye. I'm decorated FIB agent Stephen.
Body Haynes. Work to match the driver.
The police department and sheriff's office are fighting a war out here every day. In a city where dreams too often become wet. Tears. The Los Santos docks. This is where it all begins. The second largest port in the world. The great orifice of American capitalism. Stuff coming in. Garbage going out.
Making decisions
and
is stressful.
Over 2 million containers a day. God only knows what. The cartels pay off some low-level schlub, and suddenly you've got military-grade weapons, badly cut crystal meth, and grade A yayo from Mexico flooding our streets. And once it hits the hood, it's anarchy. Sign of murder. Maybe the Chinese are slipping some of our high-security weapons systems in with the recycling.
Think long and
hard. We're giving up our national security for nothing? Who knows? Who cares? As long as the financial party continues, we'll just keep picking up the pieces.
A word to the wise, kids. Never use PCP. It makes you want to punch cops or run around naked, not necessarily always in that order. Most of the time, this illicit cargo makes it straight to the gangs. But sometimes an
how many cars you got in this garage again?
A shit after a pipe or two of pleasure dust. Vagos, bloodthirsty Chicanos with a predilection for pain, papaya juice, and spicy plantains. They're one of the largest Mexican street gangs in the city, with rumored connections to several major mafias.
If you can think it, I can do it.
The other half is with informants. Sometimes you need to become the bad guys to bust the bad guys. All right, guys, let's go. When the Ballas and the families aren't shooting each other,
there it is.
They're selling the dope that the junkies are shooting. Families love sports almost as much as they love fame. Flashy, airy, competitive, and aggressive. They are lifelong bitter enemies of the boss. Wearing the colors of the feud or the corkers, the families call themselves gang green. Of course, like all families, they love a good
squad. Do you need a drink? Bubbles?
Subdivided
or something?
Sets, such as the Chamberlain Gangsters and the Carson Avenue set. It turns out the families love shooting each other. Almost as much as they love shooting ballas. Now the LSPD have had many run-ins with various family sets over the years. With the ballas, the FIB take a more community outreach approach. Hey guys, stay out of trouble.
No rush at all.
Now the ballas fly the colors of the Los Santos Panic, or the Boars, purple, because they are the bruise on the face of this city. While some thugs obviously prefer four wheels, other desperados prefer two. Leather, exhaust, and drugs.
Whatever you desire.
This isn't an exotic
technology and budget permitting.
These are one of the nation's toughest outlaw motorcycle gangs. The Lost. Rumors are they get a new tattoo for every person they stab.
And it's definitely okay for your motorcycle mama to show her breasts to your friends. The FIB has been tracking the Lost for years. We've jumped from coast to coast.
Life is hard when you can have anything.
Midwest than a tornado spotter. When they're not running, Matt, they're smoking it. Or so I hear a dangerous new drug on the streets called toilet cleaner. And believe me, your toilet will be cleaned after you've smoked some of it. Of course, Vinewood being Vinewood, it's not all about leathery dudes trying to show off on their motorbikes or roided up gangbangers stuck in some
making decisions is stressful.
This is the town that made mass murder into nostalgia. Of course, to become truly popular, your murder
girl is looking good
and gruesome. In a town full of alien spotters, adults dressed as zombies, and entertainers dressed as cartoon characters, it takes something particularly awful to really catch people's attention. The famous unsolved murder of a Vinewood starlet is one such case. For years, horny nerds have wondered what happened to Leonora Johnson, and if they would have plucked up the courage
think
to
long
speak to her
and hard.
Or kill her themselves. It's inspired filmmakers, writers, and copycat
looks
killers.
Almost as good as you.
Conspiracy theorists have blamed various celebrities, the mayor, the Soviets, short skirts, women's liberation, and hidden aliens embedded amongst us.
But not all crime is premeditated. Maybe drinking's your thing. Look at this.
You've got an eye for this stuff.
There doesn't always need to be criminal intent to cause serious criminal damage. Or maybe you're just an overprivileged poppycock, living on daddy's pension and protesting about the unfairness of capitalism. Maybe stock market manipulation is your bag, or loan sharking, double identity theft, assassination,
or even worse, swinging. On our next episode, I, Stephen Haynes, will show you the...
How many cars you got in this garage again?
Illegal street racing, cocaine, and vice. Yes, speed, snort, and sex. The alliterative threesome...
Should give you the right amount of bounce. She looked pretty.
Grass, Bavarian car key party, dried Greek rub greens, and Norwegian salmon rancher surprise. Yum! Fat chips! Get crunching and stop crunches! We've made healthy snacking cool! Princess Mama Bubblegum!
Thank you.
need a drink? Bubbles or something?
Fish or surf clam, he only likes octopus. But this is a terrible analogy. Where's that useless cutesy sidekick of yours that walks on the tips of it?
Be your best you. Remember, I'll do anything as long as it's legal. Ish.
I'm on the clock. What you want? Some wheels? I'll get back to it then.
What's she need, then? Anything I can do? Anything at all?
Victory for the working man!
My work in this job.
But our workplace is destroyed!
Ah, hell go on welfare! Kick back!
That's some powerful machinery. Looking good. Bodywork to match the driver.
Hey, Imminent Rage, you pathetic hypocrite. I was just eating some whale sashimi and a manatee steak when my thoughts turned to you. Dumb, slow vegetarians whom the state will no longer protect. See you around, schmucko.
Whatever you desire. Technology and budget permitting. Got some machine under that bonnet.
Exploiting people mercilessly. My father made a fortune strip mining, whaling, dumping toxic pollution, and marketing tobacco. He was a womanizer. And my father, he belittled me constantly. And then he died before he could write me out of his will. And so I became the majority shareholder in a huge multinational company.
Making decisions is stressful. Is looking good.
A superhero. Through the art of self-medication, and a freak green energy accident, which gave me unnatural godlike powers, I became impotent crazy. Wait, what's that? It's my echo sense going off. That man isn't.
Think long and hard. You got in this garage again?
Even though I am otherwise entirely incompetent.
Impotent Rage, there's some trouble down by the
river.
Fascism never sleeps. Violet!
I'm over here.
Of course you are. Why are you wearing that ridiculous outfit?
I thought superheroes run around in their underwear, so should their sister.
Do you need a drink? Bubbles or something?
Violet, it's that kind of hyper-sexualized clothing that exploits and demeans women.
Fuck me.
Fuck me! Time for impotent rage! Where is it?
Here.
For the record, this is an organic, entirely fair trade cotton one piece that is dyed in berry juice, harvested by a lesbian commune. And it's every bit as effective at fighting crime as the synthetic fibers made popular by some of my rivals. Quick, to the suit-up montage!
Braxton?
What's this?
That's the cost to animate.
No rush at all.
Elaborate and lengthy suit-up montage.
Got it. Okay, skip the montage. Let's go straight to impotent rage!
Looks almost as good as you.
Birds that travel through San Andreas. But every day, hundreds of thousands of birds are slaughtered by a not-so-silent predator, windmills. So-called environmentalists...
Whatever you desire.
...need to destroy our...
Technology and budget permitting.
...oil industry will lead to noisy, nature-killing windmills literally in your backyard. At San Andreas Water and Power, we're working with state and local officials to make sure that windmills and solar panels don't ruin our pristine environment. Let's keep the power on. Nature, and in particular our beautiful birds, will thank you. Nothing is more...
Life is hard when you can have anything.
...moving windmill. They, like any half-sentient creature, much prefer 100-acre industrial plants spewing out noxious chemicals. Let's all work together to preserve our environment. San Andreas Water and Power.
No more fracking! No more fracking! No more fracking! No more
making decisions
fracking!
Is stressful. You've got an eye for this stuff.
Always trying to stop loving people from fracking. What century are you living in? If these three men want to frack each other, what business is it of yours? If these two want to spit roast this guy, why do I care?
What? But they want to drill really deep and make a mess.
What? They say that's the joy of fracking. Why often this happens?
Think long and hard. Don't she look pretty? How many cars you got in this garage again? Your cosmetics are on point.
Thank you.
How are you?
Good to see you, boss.